Most of the technology transfer offices' licenses are probably of similar flavors, and they really boil down to three components. There's a royalty component, there's a equity component, and then there's the rights of the patent in terms of exclusivity and term. So, you know, and those are all various different levers that one can pull or use depending on the technology. And it's also, I'm sure, from the OTL standpoint or technology transfer offices, they look at various technology and the potential and the time to development, et cetera, to really influence which is most important. So Stanford also is very good about how it distributes equity. So I think the way, at least it's when we did our license, and maybe it's changed now, I don't think so, it was really essentially in a rough cut divided. The royalty stream was divided one third amongst inventors, one third to the department, and then one third to the university. Very easy, and that was how they, for the license, both royalty and equity that came back was distributed. So in our license, it was again those levers, like how much do I think the royalty is worth? Is it based on total sales? Once we hit that milestone, is it based on a per unit amount? Equity, what percentage seems right for us as inventors? And it was a group of us because there were some other teammates I had, and that would be then divided for the university, the division, and myself and my teammates. And then finally, most importantly, investors, do you have exclusive rights? And I should mention that exclusive rights is also related to field of use. So patents obviously are very specific, but oftentimes they can be, you know, much broader than one thinks and when your first application. So there's also time spent on this is going to be used for what type of monitoring and what space and for the length of the patent and exclusively to use so no one else could license it. So those are all the different things that inventors really need to think about. And it's probably no magic formula. It all depends on what's relevant to your business and when you think you'll have royalties or not. And also what investors want to say. Investors don't want to be paying huge royalty sums to a university, but they also understand that without the university, paying for the process, paying for us to be fellows in the program to find this need, there may not have been anything to invest in. So it's, I think most of the people, at least in the Bay Area and Silicon Valley, understand all of the great technology that have come from Stanford. And so it was a very easy process initially to get through that license. It was very, because I think everyone was aligned in where we want to go. We want to see the technology developed. I wanted to develop it, and they said, like, you're definitely the best person to move it forward.